This is the next video, the second video about Ludwig van Beethoven Sonata number 15, played and performed by Daniel Barenboim. So we have to be incredibly careful. This sonata is the highest one. We have to be incredibly careful because we have this sick disease within. And very few healers have had this chance or opportunity to come to me and start healing. But even then, they have not been allowed to fully integrate and touch with the whole disease. Only the female ones, the female healers, have had some simpler access to these inner channels, mostly about heart chakra and these levels. You know, it has been painful. But usually when I think, for example, about the play at this woman, they would kind of have no access to this disease, by the way, because it's just too gentle, fragile, and they would freak out or something. It has to do like how our planet was destroyed or something. So there's this aspect of game code where you can destroy planets, but we don't do this, okay? So even if we were attacked like this, from our perspective last night, there's this huge mess and chaos from my child's perspective in this part of the universe, and Pleiad is like the only light warrior, light sword that's appearing in this dark chaos that's falling apart, you know, in this middle of night. This is like the only warrior that's suddenly flashing his word in this falling apart chaos, dark and ugly one. So then I got this realization, you know, or thought about this, like the Mayan people were like attempting to lessen the warrior aspect of the Pleiades, which might have not been the correct thing, by the way. They just choose to take down the warrior one, like the warrior vibe of the Pleiades. But while in fact, just this advertisement about female. Parfum workshop or something about female. But because of the war zone was so tough, you know, it might have not been a good idea to kind of lessen the warrior vibe of the Pleiades. But this is what the Mayan people were doing. And it can't say like, you know, it was for the highest purpose. Maybe it was like a little bit evil or something. To take down, if you think about the Mayan, not the Nazi ones, but the Mayan people who had to these priests who were making human sacrifice, okay? It was quite low, it's very, not warriorish, okay? It was interesting to see how they devalued the real warrior of human being with this practice, you know? Technological mouse away because it was disturbing me. So it's like maybe it was like a subtle female influence. Why was female regarded impure and almost non-beneficial? Because it was always kind of making sure, you know, that the life would continue in this war zone. But at the same time, it was dangerous to go to the female, you know, because it would require very high level adjustment to kind of end this brag, you know. Nobody wants to hear how soldier shares his war zone stories. It's forbidden to talk about this. And I don't think it's the main reason about killing humans or not, whether or not you should talk about this. It's about the female does not want to hear the war stories. So we can only look at the light now, while having these deeper, tragical inner wounds within. They're not even interested. The war is being rejected. It's not allowed to be talked about, no? And that's a very good sacred reason why. And maybe I only realized this after visiting Pushkar, you know. If there's a war in the area, this whole past life incarnation cycle, it gets more sacred, you know. And it's not allowed to talk in highly, like, female, civilized, like, welcoming area about this tough people, tough zones. It can only be done in a very gentle way. And I was asked last night to heal like this vibration on this planet that you call Varanasi or Maranasi. Varanasi is a city in India, and Maranasi is like the happy Nazi camps in Germany, you know. And I was also asked, you know, to please trap us, you know, because this freedom is too horrible. I was visiting Lord of the Rings movie. And there they talk about yogis going into tough dungeons, and I was also asked if I can do this again in a physical life. Like, don't die, go back as a warrior and fight your freaking, like, fight to the end, you know, is the message. But, you know, it requires, like, a certain degree of diplomacy, like this skill where you don't offend others while speaking. How to handle these female frequencies as well. Because if you're doing zazen and stuff like this, you're disregarding sometimes the inner purity of like a beautiful heart that some people have, you know. Some people were compassionate during the war zones. They were not included in these fights. And we have paid almost no attention to them. We're only talking about these people who won the war and who kind of fought in the war, you know. We're just not talking about these compassionate people who were also present during the war times. Not fighting, not shooting, choosing to stay home and take care of the family. I'm talking about the inner feminine we have been suppressing for so long. And it's screaming, stop right now, not anymore. And it has very good reason to scream out like this. The wars are damaging our planet. And the natural world has to kind of do something to offer her medicine. And if we silence these voices again and again, the nature cannot heal, it must be suppressed. Stuff like, I make small pause here because there's something in the kitchen happening.